I think in the history of the chorus, there was the Big Bang, the Supremes, and John Strumwassers.
John cries all the time. He cries at rehearsal, he cries in concerts, he cries with friends. He cried at a couple of board meetings, but not for the reason you'd think he would cry at a board meeting, but like something moved him. And at our 25th anniversary concert, which was at the Boston Opera House, and John sang the solo for a piece called The Great Peace March by Holly Near, and the audience, when they heard he was doing the solo, started like going wild and everything, and he started crying during the solo. And he got through it and everything. And what I think now is, with John leaving, which is unfathomable, I think we're gonna cry. I think we'll turn that around.
It's been an incredible journey, but tonight we're losing. Tonight we're losing one of our founding members, John Strumwasser.
I said I wasn't going to cry. Well, I guess any of you who know me know that that's not realistic.
The chorus started as a result of the San Francisco Gay Men's Chorus tour, to be in the Opera House in Boston and see this wave of gay men in tuxedos come onto the stage and sing as gay men was just absolutely like nothing I had ever seen before. And it instilled such, I guess, pride and amazement to actually see that happen. I just knew that someday I needed to do that. Let's just say that the birth, there was difficult labor involved in the birth of the chorus. I personally was a little nervous. I really wasn't out very much at all, and particularly not at work, and so that it was a difficult threshold for me to cross, but important enough that I had to do it.
37 years ago, a bunch of us started this thing. 37 years later, Jim Anderson and I are the two remaining people who have been here from day one.
One of the first people that I met when we were in rehearsals, you know, for our very first concert, and we instantly became friends. And the friendship has continued even through, you know, like we now every once in a while go out for our dinosaur dinners. And, you know, like, just talk about what it was like way back when.
Certainly it was intimidating to be up there as gay men singing out in public in Boston for the first time. And that was the way I came out. So it was a very radical thing for me to do personally.
There was a line around the block to get in, but they had to turn people away, standing room only. We walked into the church, filed in, and got a standing ovation. We hadn't even opened our mouths yet, and we got a standing ovation. It was a tremendously powerful experience. I mean, I was crying so hard I couldn't sing the first two songs because I couldn't see the conductor.
At the very end, we had no idea what they were going to do, and then they just burst into screams and everything. It was wonderful.
I guess I'd have to say my least favorite, not memory, but set of memories about the BGM, of my time with BGMC, was all of the death during the AIDS crisis. I don't know that any of us were prepared at that age to have all of our friends dying around us. There was a time when we were singing at memorial services, and we were doing them every week. One concert we did, I believe it was Hidden Legacies, which was a quote cantata about the AIDS epidemic. And we lost two chorus members in the week before we did that performance. So it had a huge impact on us, but it also was a tremendous unifier for for us, and it's something that was so significant in our development that it's something that those of us who went through it don't want people to forget. You can love whomever you may. So yes, I did meet my husband in the chorus, my husband Steve the Wonderful.
And I asked him if he ever went to movies. He said, well, I like movies, but I don't go. And I said, well, we should do that. We should go to movie and have dinner. Now, meanwhile, I'm telling all my friends, I don't know what he thinks it is, but I think it's a date.
And I of course, told my friends, I'm going to the movies next weekend. Steve asked me, he sort of prefaced the question with something about, I have a question to ask you, or something along those lines. I kind of knew what was coming, and I definitely wanted to. So he said, would you be interested in dating? And in a split second, I said, yes. So we started dating.
It wasn't exactly, I have a question to ask. It was, as I recall, I think I'm fortified enough.
That's right.
Would you be interested in dating? Yes. Talk about your high points in the chorus.
Right, yeah.
Often talk about how the chorus is a place where you make friends. John's friendship with me really is a deep example of the kind of friendship that you can create. Because people always saw us together, especially new members of the chorus, and they were curious, and they said, well, are you two guys an item? And John and I would look at each other and then look back and say, nope, we're just sisters.
He's been probably my mainstay in this chorus. I probably would not have stayed as long if it were not for him.
He's been here since the beginning, and just that, knowing that somebody has done that is such an inspiration to so many of us.
It's been a blessing to know you for the last 30 years. You have been a true inspiration from the moment I met you.
As we see more and more gay bars closing and losing spaces for our community, it's that much more important to me that we still have spaces to come together as gay men and in community to do the beautiful things that we do here. And that wouldn't have happened without John and the other founding members of the chorus.
He definitely showed me the ropes and has always just been like this tree that you could lean on, you could get shelter under. I know, the giving tree, blah, 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 but he really is.
There's something about when John hugs you, it's almost like he has taken every hug that he's given for every member that he's encountered, every hug given back to him. There's some sort of learned love and wisdom that he imparts in every embrace that he gives you.
In my life, I have loved and I have been loved. And I really thought I knew what that was, but not until I met John did I know how much of me fully, wholly, could be in the expression, I love you.
I brought a lot of me and left it here. And it really means the world to me to have been a part of this organization for all this time.
I can't thank you enough for what you've done for the chorus, but more importantly, I can't thank you enough for what you've done for me. You know, like, you've shown me what being a true gentleman is, and, you know, like, what being just an amazing person is. So thank you, John. I love you so much.